Good evening. Welcome to this year's swearing-in ceremony as we pass on our elected duties. Councilman Drummond and I would welcome everybody to this event. If everybody would please rise, and I would like to invite Dr. Dasawan to preside and give us the invocation.
Good evening. Let us pray. Our gracious Almighty God, we request your presence and blessings during this ceremony at the City of Fairfax. Give wisdom, strength, and unity of the Spirit to the leaders and the citizens of this great city. Bless our mayor, the members of the City Council, the members of the school board, city staff, and the community at large. We ask for your blessings upon those that have served this city and now moving on to new adventures. Together, we celebrate the past, present, and the future progress of the City of Fairfax. Our gracious God of the human race, we ask for your everlasting blessings upon the City of Fairfax, the State of Virginia, and the United States of America. Amen.
Please remain standing. I'd like to ask the presentation of the colors by the City of Fairfax Police and Fire Joint Color Guard. Troop 1887 in the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing for the national anthem sung by Rachel Harrington.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Before we get started with our swearing-in ceremony tonight, we decided to try something a little different, and we're going to take a moment to honor those who have served this community for the last 6 years, our outgoing council members, on the same evening that we're honoring our new council members. So with that, I would like to just mention a couple of things, if I may. What's wrong? Yeah. Oh, you can sit. I'm sorry. Oh, my gosh. Sorry about that. Wait a minute. If I have to stand, right? Let's... I see my brother in the audience. He's going to give me grief about that one. We just concluded our final meeting of the 2012-2014 City Council. And I think all of us that have had the privilege and the honor of serving with Councilman Drummond and Councilman Stombries really feel very strongly that we're going to miss them. It's not that we always agree. It's not that we always see eye to eye. But both gentlemen brought a sense of commitment, of purpose, of humor to some of the very tedious work of local government. And I just want to say, speaking personally, I've known both gentlemen long before they were elected to the City Council, and I've had the privilege of serving with many people over the course of 21 years. And I will tell you that there's no two finer individuals than Steve Stombries and Dan Drummond. And when I think of Dan, here it goes. Dan, we had a little bit of a running joke. Those of you who've known Dan for a number of years will remember his old handle, his old email address, Newspaper Dan. Remember that? Because it was sort of telephone, telegraph, teledan, and Dan would report on it right away. But Dan brought that same kind of communication skill to the City Council as well, where he kept his finger on the pulse of the community. He communicated well with the community, introduced me, frankly, along with some other folks, but introduced me to Twitter and Facebook and how to use it effectively. Dan also, very candidly, helped re-engage his community in a way that hadn't been done and that could be a model or should serve as a model for other communities throughout the City of Fairfax. The Southeast Fairfax area, Green Acres in particular, and Dan, you've done a great job with that. Mr. Stombries, Steve, is a longtime friend as well, and I just want to say a word or two about Steve. Steve, in particular, had the ability, the unique ability, during very tense council meetings and closed sessions in the back room, where we might be, you know, a little bit of this from time to time. He could diffuse any tense situation with just one quick-witted comment. And it's something that I'm going to miss terribly. And Steve brought, I think, incredible vigor to the council. He was able to juggle a very demanding career and demanding job with his duties here on the City Council. And in particular, he brought a new and renewed focus to the environmental issues that we deal with here in the city. We've had a recycling program for 21 years, 20 years in the city. But Steve was able to pursue with vigor an opportunity to expand our recycling program, and it now ranks as one of the top recycling programs in the state of Virginia, and Steve deserves a great deal of credit for that. So with that, I would just like to, on behalf of my colleagues on the City Council, the rest of your colleagues, and our new colleagues, and the community, I want to thank you for your service. It means a great deal to all of us. You're going to get a chance to make a few remarks, but before we do that, I would like to recognize a couple of other people to come forward. And the first I would like to call on is Delegate David Bulova. Or why don't I call you both up, Chad Peterson and David Bulova, Senator Chad Peterson.
Great. What an honor and a privilege it is to be here with you all this evening, and especially to recognize my friends Dan Drummond and Steve Stombries. Both of whom I've had the pleasure of working with for a number of years, and what really sticks out in my mind is that they represent all the best of why people get involved with public service. And if you take a look at their resumes, it's loaded with things like Little League, with getting involved with their church, with the swim club, with the American Legion. And they brought that kind of spirit and that dedication to the community, to the City Council. And what's even more incredible, of course, is that once they were on City Council, those are still the things that they did that kept them connected to the community. And I know in their term, they've had a lot of trials, tribulations, a lot of tough decisions to make. But at the end of the day, the question is, did you make a difference? And they really, really have. They've made a huge difference. They've left this city in better shape than they found it. And there's no higher honor and privilege to be an elected official than at the end of the day to be able to say that. I'll let Senator Peterson say a few words, and then we have resolutions to present to them on behalf of the Virginia House of Delegates and the Senate of Virginia to recognize their contributions to the community.
Thank you, David. You know, the year 2008 will always be known as a remarkable year in American political history. And it's because Dan Drummond and Steve Stombers were elected that year, of course. You know, they brought a lot of vigor to the city council. You know, both of them grew up in Virginia, but they didn't grow up here. And sometimes, believe it or not, the city council can be a little bit of a sort of a Fairfax High School mafia. And it was good to get some outsiders. Yes, Scott, I know it's, believe it or not. But they came in and they brought vigor, they brought energy. They were young fathers, and you know, that was a great perspective. It was necessary, and it was greatly added. And we're going to miss them. I know. I'm sure they're going to be back in public service soon enough. But they did a great job, and I'm really happy they did. Thank you.
So on behalf of the General Assembly of Virginia, the House of Delegates, I'm very pleased to present to Council and Daniel F. Drummond House Joint Resolution number 5006, commending his service to the City of Fairfax. And before I turn this over, I want to make sure I compare how much bigger this is than the Senate's.
We have a tight budget. All right. Well, I could have had the larger plaque, but the speaker ruled it out of order. So the bottom line is this is on for Steve Stombers. I could read it, but it'd be very embarrassing. But it really says essentially what a great person he is. And on behalf of the Virginia State Senate in tandem with the House, we recognize Councilman Stombers for his service to the City of Fairfax and thank him.
Mr. Drummond, I will recognize you first for some closing comments.
Thank you, Mayor Silverthorne. Thank you, Delegate Bova. Thank you, Senator Peterson. As the mayor said, I've known these gentlemen for a very, very long time. They're very good friends of mine. For the last 6 years, it's been an honor and a privilege to serve on your city council. I would not have been able to run for office, attend meetings, spend time dedicated to the job without the love and support of my family, my wife Carrie, and our three children, Sadie, Patrick, and Liam. Thanks to all of you. This has certainly been a family affair. When I first ran in 2008, I did so because I wanted to make a difference in our community. And collectively, we have done that. We have made a difference, whether it's new buildings, parks, activities, or continuing to maintain our great services at the lowest possible cost to our residents and businesses. As your city council, we've made a positive impact on the lives of the 23,000 people who call the city home. Over the last 6 years, we have seen a lot of progress and changes in our city. And while the mayor and council ultimately get to cast the votes, it's the people of this community who really make change happen and move us forward. It's people like Ben Pratt, who came to city council and suggested we start officially observing Veterans Day as a city, as we now do. It's through the collective efforts of our boards and commissions that came together to support and advocate for our new downtown park. And it's my daughter, Sadie, who told me we needed to make sure that anyone could live in our city, prompting our city's first ever affordable housing policy and prompting a long overdue discussion about the cost of housing in our fair city. No matter if you're an adult, a group, or a child, you can make a difference here in the city of Fairfax, and you all play a role in shaping the future of the city. As I leave council, I know that your mayor and council and school board will continue to follow that great tradition we have in the city of listening and responding to the will of the community, doing what's right, ensuring that we maintain the sense of place the city of Fairfax is known for. On a personal note, I'll certainly miss my colleagues and the experience we've shared. Each one of them has been a friend and provides leadership to this community. Michael, your passion for economic development has helped us bring focus to the need to be more strategic and plan for our future. David, you're thoughtful and have helped me understand the long-term implications of our actions, as well as being the consummate historian reminding us of our past. Jeffrey, as your mother would call you. As the longest serving member of council, you have shown what it is to be a model local elected official who is passionate and dedicated to our city. And Ellie, you have a perspective that is always needed, reminding us of what makes the city unique and different. And Steve, you're a great leader who's focused on making the city better, an even better place to live, especially to become greener and more sustainable. And finally, Mr. Mayor, what can I say? We've known each other a very, very long time. First, when I was a reporter and covered the city's decision under your leadership to buy open space for parks and preservation, to working on your campaigns, and then to eventually serving with you. You've been a mentor, a friend, and someone who has been like a big brother I never had. So thank you for everything. And to the two new members of council, Janice and Nancy, good luck to both of you. I know that you will serve our community well. And finally, to our community, thank you again for the opportunity to serve. It's truly been an honor to be on your council. And while I won't be on council, I will continue to be involved and engaged, whether it's FPOIC, our Fairfax Frogs, or just seeing every run around town. And being that it's in summer, I'm sure I'll see you at Woody's Ice Cream and probably buying the mayor an ice cream cone. So thank you again. God bless America, and God bless the city of Fairfax.
Thank you very much. It's been a tremendous honor for me to serve on the City Council for the past 6 years, and tonight I will conclude that service with a simple and short message of thanks and encouragement. We've only been allotted 2 minutes. First of all, I want to thank Mayor Scott Silverthorne for his leadership and guidance throughout my entire service on the City Council. Scott, you've been a great friend and a mentor. And I cannot thank you enough for all that you've done for me and for our council and for our community. I'd also like to thank Mayor Lederer, who I also served with on the City Council. Rob dedicated much of his adult life to serving the City of Fairfax, first on the City Council and also as mayor. The city is a better place because of Rob's efforts, and I look forward to joining Rob and Mayor John Mason in the ranks of retired public servants of Fairfax. I would also like to thank the men and women that I was so lucky enough to serve on the City Council with. Gary Rasmussen, the late Joan Cross, Jeff Greenfield, David Meyer, Dan Drummond, Ellie Schmidt, Michael DeMarco. There were a lot of long nights, long hours. We argued with each other. We debated difficult issues. We listened to each other. And we learned from each other. Ultimately, we grew together and we accomplished some amazing things. You are all amazing public servants, and I will truly miss calling each one of you my colleagues. I would be remiss if I didn't thank Bob Sisson and David Hodgkins and Melanie Burrell and the entire staff here at City Hall. They work so hard behind the scenes. Everything that everybody up here takes credit for would not be possible without their efforts and their dedication. I also want to share some words of encouragement tonight. I welcome the new members of the City Council and the School Board. Welcome to the close-knit fraternity of the men and women who have been elected to public office in Fairfax. I encourage you to listen to the residents, listen to your colleagues, and listen to your heart. Do what you think is right when it's easy and everybody agrees with you. But do what you think is right when it's difficult and you find yourself a solitary voice alone in a wilderness. To the city staff, I encourage you to take heart in the fact that the work that you do every day really matters. Your efforts are noticed and appreciated by everyone who lives or learns, works or grows, eats, works, plays, rides, or recycles in the city of Fairfax. You have impacted more lives in this community than you will ever know. And to the residents of the city, I encourage you to get involved. I encourage you to find a way to make this community a little bit better. Every minute that you spend, every ounce of energy that you provide, every bit of experience that you offer will come back to you tenfold. The city of Fairfax is truly a place where everyone gets more than they give. And finally, I want to thank the members of my family. My stepfather, Jerry Goodale, is here tonight. My mother-in-law, Judy Lamorte, is here. My brother, Rich Stombries, who allows me to be at two polling places at once. Thank you for your support. And I want to thank my wonderful wife, Kristen, and our three children, Katie, Ellie, and Jimmy. He's waving to me. None of the things that I have done or have tried to do would have been possible without them. They rejoiced by my side when I succeeded, and they were a source of comfort and consolation when I failed. I'm so grateful for their love and support, and I look forward, in fact, I can't wait to start the next chapter of our lives together tomorrow morning. Thank you.
Mr. Drummond, can you join me? May I ask Carrie Drummond and Kristen Stombries to join us, please?
Is Kristen here?
By the way, that's Rich Stombries right there. He looks an awful lot like Steve. That was the inside joke there about being in two polling places at the same time. On behalf of the members of the City Council and the staff, we want to thank you all for sharing both Dan and Steve with us. So thank you very much. Hold on, we'll have plenty of time for pictures later. And then the last thing I want to do is present to Councilman Stombries on behalf of the members of the City Council and the staff. There you go, Steve.
Thank you.
And Councilman Drummond.
I would now like to introduce the City Clerk, Melanie Burrell, to administer the oath of office to Mayor Silverthorne.
Mr. Mayor, if you can raise your right hand.
Well, do you know it by heart?
Nope, like that. Repeat after me. Scott Silverthorne.
I, Scott Silverthorne.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And perform all of the duties incumbent upon me.
And perform all the duties incumbent upon me.
As mayor of the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
As mayor of the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my abilities.
According to the best of my abilities.
So help me God.
So help me God. Thank you. Thank you.
And now I'd like to invite Electra Board Chairman Rick Harrington for the presentation of the certificate of election.
Good evening. Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for coming out this beautiful evening to bear witness to this representative government we have here in the city. These elected officials are your choices to represent them in the halls of government. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Want to do a quick one right there? Well, good afternoon, good evening again. Members of the City Council, members of the School Board, Treasurer Sebelia, Clerk of the Court Fry, Senator Peterson, Delegate Bulova, distinguished guests and ladies and gentlemen. 2 years ago, I stood before you in this beautiful Veterans Amphitheater and took the oath of office as the 10th individual to serve as mayor of the City of Fairfax. I was then, and as I am now, deeply grateful and humbled by the confidence you have placed in me. To the newest members of the City Council, I wish you congratulations. I look forward to working with you and our returning council members for the people of our wonderful community. To the former members of council, I want to again thank you for your service and wish you the very best in your new endeavors. I have a sneaking suspicion we're going to see you both again. I am very proud of our new City Council tonight. I look forward to the collegiality and mutual respect as we deal with the many challenges that we face ahead. I have known most of the council members for many years and consider them all to be friends. I am certain that we will always find ways to work together, even when we don't always stand together. As mayor, my top three priorities remain clear. One, strengthening our local economy. Two, renewing civic and neighborhood pride. And three, enhancing our quality of life through expanding our parks, recreational, and cultural activities. First, our local economy. I'm pleased to say that the city has turned the economic corner over the past 2 years. Last month, the city's unemployment rate posted its best number in nearly 6 years, just 3.6%. During my first term as mayor, our bond rating agencies reaffirmed our AAA bond rating status, one of only a handful of jurisdictions to achieve this distinction in the Commonwealth of Virginia. However, to keep our taxes low, we must have a strong business community. Our top priorities must be the redevelopment of the Fairfax Boulevard and continuing the progress that we've made in our city's historic downtown. Through our comprehensive rewrite of our zoning ordinance, we are pursuing opportunities to streamline city government, including the lessening of the regulatory burdens that we all face here in the city of Fairfax to do business or redevelop the aging shopping centers we have in our community. This evening, I am also proposing a complete review of our tax structure here in the city. This will include the B-poll tax, or business and professional occupational licensing taxes, the meals tax, the bank franchise tax, and all other taxes that the city levies. While it's too early to predict if major change is needed in our tax structure, I do believe that it's important that we remain competitive in the metropolitan region. Even with this review that I encourage us to undertake, it's important that we keep in mind that city residents still pay the second lowest overall tax rates in Northern Virginia. This fall, we will also partner with George Mason University and the Northern Virginia Regional Commission to explore ways to enhance our historic downtown. To quote a former mayor, who happens to be in the audience, Mayor Mason, the three R's are critical to our downtown's success. They include restaurants, retail, and residential. Secondly, I believe we owe it to future generations to preserve our open space, protect our environment, and expand outdoor opportunities for all of our residents. I want Fairfax to continue to be the place where kids and adults alike can play and have fun every day. Just tonight, your City Council approved our Parks and Recreation Strategic Master Plan, the first of its kind for our community. This ambitious plan will serve as a future blueprint for our outstanding Parks and Recreation Department. Most impressive about this plan is that 23% of our community participated in its drafting. As we work to improve our downtown for residents and visitors alike, we will launch a series of events which I hope will meet great success. These include a monthly downtown event dubbed TGIF, Thank God It's Fairfax, and Rock the Block, both beginning next month. Finally, we are a diverse community of hardworking people and close-knit neighborhoods. We all treasure our history, the history we share as a courthouse town, and have tremendous pride in being an independent city. As our neighborhoods age, however, it becomes increasingly important to build civic pride and stronger civic associations. We need to address the unique needs and diverse issues that we have throughout our city. We must enlist residents to help identify and prioritize neighborhood concerns, then engage our city departments and individual civic associations to help make these neighborhoods stronger. If there isn't a civic association in existence, then we ought to start one. We ought to partner with key individuals and start one. Localized issues such as public safety or cut-through traffic or stormwater runoff, these aren't new issues to our community. But I believe our approach in engaging our community can always be improved. Our goal should be to provide meaningful and affirmative change in our neighborhoods and for residents to become more involved in their community and the city as a whole. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been proud to serve on your city council, and I'm deeply honored to serve as your mayor. I've often said that the city of Fairfax is rich in history with unlimited possibilities for the future. With your help, we can achieve great things. It's time to get to work. Thank you again for giving me this great honor of serving as your mayor. I won't let you down. Thank you.
Now invite City Clerk Melanie Burrell to come forward to administer the oath of office to the City Council.
If you could all please stand. Raise your right hand. And repeat after me. Hopefully the wind won't blow.
Hold on.
No, it's okay. I state your name. Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear
that I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
And perform all of the duties incumbent upon me.
And perform all the duties incumbent upon me.
As a member of the City Council for the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
As a member of the City Council for the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my abilities.
According to the best of my abilities.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
All right, yeah.
I would now like to invite Electoral Board Chairman Rick Harrington to come forward for the presentation of certificates of election.
I've already had my speaking part. Commonwealth of Virginia, to all whom these presents shall come, greetings. This is to certify that Jeffrey Greenfield was duly elected member City Council. Yeah. Congratulations. To all whom these presents shall come, greetings. This is to certify that David L. Meyer was duly elected member City Council. To all whom these presents shall come, greetings. This to certify Eleanor D. L.A. Schmidt was duly elected member City Council. These presents shall come, greetings. This is to certify Michael J. DeMarco was duly elected member City Council. Congratulations. So to all whom these presents shall come, greetings. This is to certify Janice Miller was duly elected member City Council. Whom these presents shall come, greetings. This is to certify Nancy Fry Loftus was duly elected member City Council.
Thank you.
would now like to invite individual members of the City Council to give brief remarks, starting with Council Member Jeffrey Greenfield.
Dan was right. I really do only hear the word Jeffrey when I'm in trouble with my mother, so. Distinguished guests, friends, and neighbors, it was May 7th, 2002, when the city made history by electing three women to serve on the City Council. Fast forward 12 years, and you've done it again. I welcome the opportunity to serve with each of you as we face together the challenges of keeping the City of Fairfax the best place to live, work, and raise a family. To my colleagues, Dan and Steve, I truly enjoyed working with you, and I look forward to seeing you in the community. And just remember, when you come back to council, the five-minute rule still applies. I'm honored that you return me to an 11th term, and I thank you for your continued vote of confidence and support. Let me take just a moment to thank the people who helped get me here. My parents, who taught me that you can accomplish anything you set your mind to. My mom in particular, who's home in the comfort of her air-conditioned TV room watching. I love you, Mom. My wife, for your steadfast support. You, the voters, and the many friends and volunteers, I would not be here without you. And a special word to our daughter, Alexandra, who finishes second grade tomorrow at Daniel's Run and will become a freshly minted third grader. Daddy loves you. Tonight, I ask for your help to address a problem that many of you don't even know exists in this city. Walk by people and you don't recognize that they're in trouble. Throughout the United States, 21.6%, or almost 16 million children, experience food insecurity at some point during a week. In Virginia, that number is roughly 16.2%, or about 300,000 children. Believe it or not, here in the City of Fairfax, 14%, yes, 14% of our kids experience hunger. We cannot solve hunger nationally until we solve it one community at a time. We live in one of the nation's wealthiest areas, but yet hunger still exists. Children are impacted the most when school is out and their families do not have enough access to school meals. So essentially, school breakfast and school lunch is what helps a family keep their kids full during school. So I ask you, will you join with me and the mayor, who has already pledged his support, to engage the community to ensure that no child in the City of Fairfax goes hungry? If you're interested in helping, please reach out to City Hall as we coordinate a task force to look at this citywide and to ensure that we're helping families who are in need in many ways we don't even know that exist. Together, we can make a difference. Thank you again for the opportunity to serve with you, for you, and with my colleagues over the next 2 years. Thank you, and God bless our fair city.
Council Member David Meyer.
Thank you, Steve. Mayor Silverthorne, fellow colleagues on City Council, members of the school board, Senator Peterson, Delegate Bulova, Mr. Fry, fellow citizens and friends, thank you for being here this evening. You know, swearing in events are always better than the swearing at events. And I'm sure we'll have a few of those in the coming term, but thankfully they are always short-lived. I joined the council with the class of 2008 when both Dan and Steve were elected with me. It will be an adjustment not to have these colleagues on council as we have all grown and learned a lot together. I personally will miss you both and thank you for your service. And I also want to add my word of thanks to Kristen Sombres and to Carrie Drummond for their support of their husbands in this during their time of service. I also want to thank Janice and Nancy for putting themselves out before the voters and congratulate them on their being elected, and I look forward to working with you as well. I also want to express my appreciation to the employees of our city, our collective appreciation for all that they do to serve us each day. These women and men care deeply about what they do and who they do it for. They intersect our lives in large and small ways, even at sometimes at the moments of our greatest peril and need. And so we thank you all for that. To the voters, I want to say thank you for to extending to me the privilege of serving you as a member of our City Council. The trust that you have extended to me and my colleagues is a sacred bond sealed in the oath that we took collectively a few moments ago. Democracy is a serious business. Just because for most of our lives we have lived with self-governance does not mean that it will, by some mystical force, continue ad infinitum for the next millennium. Each generation inherits this gift, which is often stress-tested by new economic and social changes. We as a community are required to adjust and mold our decision-making within the boundaries that are both constitutional and cultural in order to meet the new needs of an ever-changing populace. Your presence this evening is a powerful testimony to your commitment to creating and sustaining community. As I look out among our friends here, most of you, if not all of you, have in large and small ways devoted time, energy, and personal resources to move this city of Fairfax forward through the years. Tonight is one of those touchstone events where we collectively gather to recommit ourselves to this best laboratory of practicing democracy. Over the next 2 years, we will be engaged in some serious discussions about new economic development projects that hold great promise to strengthen our ability to provide the signature services and capital needs of our city. While the specific outcomes are yet to be determined, I believe how we make those critical decisions are of paramount importance. While there may be differences on the particulars, let us strive for unity of purpose. That unity is why we are all here right now. When we recognize it in each other, and when we do that, it follows that we will achieve trust, openness, accountability, participation, and effective decision making. What many of us want more than agreement is that we have simply been heard and respected. When that dynamic exists, we are no longer simply consumers of services, but we are citizens and neighbors committed to each other and committed to this place that we call home. In closing, I want to thank my family for their support, to the people who supported my campaign and voted for me, but especially to all of you for your support for all of us here on council. Thank you very much.
Council Member Ellie Schmidt.
Thank you. Good evening. Thank you, Mayor Silverthorne, and all our distinguished guests here, my colleagues, and thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us tonight. I would like to begin by expressing my thanks and appreciation to my family, my friends, supporters, and to the voters. Thank you all for being here tonight, and thank you for electing me to serve another term on Fairfax City Council. I appreciate the trust and confidence that you have placed in me. I would also like to thank Council Members Steve Stombries and Dan Drummond for your service to the city. Your dedication is very much appreciated. Thank you. It's been a pleasure to serve on council with you, and I look forward to your continued involvement in the community. I would also like to welcome new council members Janice Miller and Nancy Loftus. Looking forward to working with you and the entire City Council over the next 2 years. It has truly been an honor and a privilege to serve you on City Council these past 4 years. According to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, the definition of democracy is a form of government in which people choose leaders by voting. In the City of Fairfax, we choose our leaders by voting in local elections every 2 years. It is a great exercise in democracy. Candidates interested in serving the community reach out to citizens to discuss the issues through mailers, candidate forums, and by knocking on doors. This one-on-one interaction is invaluable. Voters turn out to elect leaders they feel will best represent them. Once elected as council members, it is our job to represent all citizens of the city and to act in your best interest. In many ways, local elections are the most important elections. Decisions made in local government have an enormous and direct impact on your lives. I believe it is important for you to be able to choose your leaders every 2 years. During this past election cycle, we all talked about our special city, and it truly is special. It is not just a housing development or a string of shopping centers. We are a community with our own sense of place. We all know that, and we all appreciate it. That is why people live here in Fairfax City, whether they've spent many years here or have just recently moved here. And we all want to preserve that. We are now at a crossroads. With aging commercial and residential areas, we are facing redevelopment opportunities. During the next 2 years, we'll need to focus on a sensible approach to these opportunities, carefully balancing intelligent growth and changing demographics with the preservation of our unique character in a way to appeal to a broad range, including families, seniors, businesses, and the university community. While we have seen improvement in the economy, we must continue our focus on economic development, maintaining the quality of our residential neighborhoods, and remaining fiscally responsible. A vibrant business community is crucial to our success as a city, and economic development is an essential focus. Maintaining and strengthening our commercial base is vital. It is important to foster an environment that is business friendly and to streamline processes to the extent possible. We are making great progress as we navigate through the zoning rewrite process. Sustaining the quality of our residential neighborhoods is also key. Successful economic development with a strong commercial base, as well as the preservation of our residential neighborhoods, will provide the tools we need to manage our fiscal responsibilities in order to keep overall taxes as low as possible, yet retain the quality of services that we all enjoy. I look forward to working together with my colleagues on council on positive and innovative solutions to the issues that affect our citizens and businesses. While we may not always agree on the matters that will come before us, I am confident that we will work together to find consensus and act in the best interest of all citizens of the city. I'm excited about the great opportunities ahead, and I am so proud and honored to be representing the City of Fairfax. Thank you very much.
Councilmember Michael DeMarco.
Well, thank you, Steve, and thank you all for being here this evening. I would like to thank my entire family, my wife, Joanne, my children, Anna, Amelia, and Antonio, for all of their support during my first term and for allowing me to share some of our time with the community. I would also like to thank my mother-in-law, who is here tonight, and the rest of my family, some of whom are watching this ceremony online. And finally, I would like to thank Shannon Duffy, my campaign manager, for her tireless support and hard work in helping me get reelected. The past 2 years have been a great experience for me. I've enjoyed working for the community and making it a better place for us and future generations to live, work, and enjoy. I am proud of the accomplishments of the mayor and city council during this past term. Unlike many political bodies, our agenda has not been one of dissension and divisiveness, but instead one of discussion and progress. Despite differences of opinion, every decision was made with the best of intentions, not one excluded. Making difficult choices, but always with the intent of equality and fairness and with the whole community in mind, not playing favorites, nor allowing emotion to dictate the outcome for the whole. I'm certain that with Mayor Silverthorne's continued leadership, that this new council will operate under the same principles of dialogue, cooperation, and commitment to purpose to continue working to reaching the goals and objectives that we have set for ourselves as a community, many of which you've already heard tonight from my colleagues. And those goals and objectives include capturing opportunities for economic growth and advancing the economic health of the city, its residents, and businesses to enable a high-performing, efficient, and effective governing structure to preserve strong neighborhoods and improve our quality of life, to create a safe and efficient transportation network that promotes walking, biking, and mass transit and reduces traffic congestion, to deliver appropriate, targeted, and sustainable mixed-use development and redevelopment projects, and to provide strong programs that educate our children and help care for those less fortunate than us. But in the end, we cannot do this alone, and I encourage the entire community, both residential and business, to be as active as possible in the governing process. Thank you all very much for your confidence, the confidence you've placed in me to serve you for another 2 years. Thank you.
Councilmember Janice Miller.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for being here. Mr. Mayor, City Council colleagues, school board members, city staff, honored guests, families, friends, and neighbors. Let me start by saying thanks. Thank you to our retiring City Council members, Steve Stombres and Dan Drummond. You've both served this community well, and I am only one of many who appreciate your service. We thank you for all you've done. I would also like to say thank you to all the family members, friends, neighbors, and acquaintances who worked to make this day a reality. Not one of us made it to this occasion without many people by our side, helping and assisting in numerous ways. We thank you for all you've done. Finally, I would like to say thank you to the many city staff members who provided a thorough and outstanding orientation. Their knowledge and guidance will give me the background information I need to make sound decisions for this community. Tonight, we take the oath of office, swearing to uphold the laws of the Commonwealth and doing our best for this city. On July 1, the rubber meets the road. And as I take office, I'm going to pledge a few things to each of you, things that I hope, general principles that I hope to uphold over the next 2 years. First of all, I hope to work hard to study issues before the City Council and make decisions based on what is good for the City of Fairfax and its citizens. Two, I plan to listen and to learn from our residents, from our city staff, and most of all from my colleagues. Listening will serve us all well because that's just one way that you learn about what you need to do. Third, I hope to partner with our mayor, Scott Silverthorne, and my fellow council members to build a sound working relationship. Teamwork is fundamental to our future growth. And fourth, I hope and I know we all plan to continue to offer outstanding municipal services. Our mayor and this city council was elected to set policy that will provide a safe community, good schools, and overall excellent services to our residents. You, as residents, deserve no less. In closing, I would like to take a point of personal privilege to recognize my family, my late husband, Jan, and my four children, Tim, Ben, Adam, and Betsy. My husband always supported my choice to serve as a longtime community volunteer and activist, and my children encouraged me to seek public office. Finally, I would like to thank you, voters and community members, for the opportunity to serve as an elected official. Outstanding communities don't just happen. They reflect leadership and partnership. I may not be the best elected official to ever serve this community, but please believe me when I say I am the most appreciative. I appreciate your faith and confidence in me and your willingness to elect me as a member of the next City Council. Again, thank you so much for attending this evening, and I will look forward to working with you and for you. Thank you so much.
Councilmember Nancy Loftus.
Thank you. Distinguished speakers and guests, my new colleagues on the council and mayor, school board, family, friends, and neighbors, thank you. But first, a very brief thank you to Dan and Steve, both for your dedication to our city, but also personally for the time, the help, the guidance that you gave to me. We've all benefited from your generosity, and I wish you both the best. I'm humbled to stand before you tonight, preparing to begin my first term on City Council. Such an honor and a privilege. It's a phrase that's repeated often, but it doesn't make it any less true. Instead, I've reflected what those two words really mean and what they mean to me. Privilege. It's a special right or a rare opportunity. I am truly grateful for the opportunity to serve my hometown. Fairfax City is a rare and special place. Honor. A thing conferred as a distinction, yes, but also to fulfill an obligation to keep an agreement. I take the oath tonight, keeping in mind that when it comes to this great obligation to all the citizens of our city of Fairfax, I do intend to keep an agreement, to do my best, to work hard, to ask tough questions, and search for solutions. It's a tall order, I know, but I look forward to the honor and privilege of working for and serving all of you. Of course, I wouldn't be here tonight without the help and support of a very long list of people. Their willingness to give so much of their time and energy was extremely humbling, but it also says so much about our city that so many cared to give their time and energy. I really would love to go through that list. Many of you are here tonight, and I see you in the audience. But we've already lost the kids to rolling down the hill, and I don't want the rest of you to jump up and join them. So I'm going to jump to some of the most important constituents to me, and I hope you'll bear with me and understand why I've selected these people. My mother-in-law, Jane Loftus. She and her husband, Bud, raised 7 kids in Old Lee Hills. Their home is still the center of the Loftus family, and she is the rock at the middle of it all. To Jane Loftus, I say, thank you for everything, but mostly for your friendship. Also, my mom and dad. Okay, I'm not gonna cry, I'm sorry. Wasn't gonna cry. I am most grateful to my parents. They had the wisdom to settle in a little 3-bedroom, 1-bathroom brick rambler in Country Club Hills when they had 4 young boys back in the early 60s. And they had the bravery to stay in that home when they added 2 girls to that family. They did add a bedroom and a bathroom, but still, it's a testament to our Fairfax City homes that you can remodel and stay in place. I learned about engaging in city life from my parents. My dad, who coached Little League for many years, I spent a lot of great memories at Chilcott Field, mostly at the snack bar, but still sometimes watching my brothers play. My mom, who was active in the garden club, a brownie troop leader. They signed us up for swim team at CCH Pool, City Summer Rec, where it cost $1 a day to go, and of course, FPYC Sports. They modeled for me a loving, patient, and active family, and through it all, they managed to keep a sense of humor. Pretty impressive. Thanks to both of you for introducing me to Fairfax City and for everything else. I also have other family members here, my Aunt Colleen and Uncle Alan, who also live in Country Club Hills, and my brother Dan and his wife Sherry, who are also constituents. Thank you. But last but certainly not least, my husband Connell and our 2 beautiful daughters, Colleen and Anastasia. Connell is the person who knows me the best of all, and yet he still seems to like me. I think he may even have voted for me, I'm not positive, but I think. our beautiful daughters, Colleen and Anna. They actually aren't here tonight because if you can indulge a proud mom, they're both in the City of Fairfax Theater Company's summer musical, Pippi Longstocking, a short commercial here, tickets on sale, July 18th through 26th. Six performances at Lanier Middle School. Everybody get your tickets. Okay. I am really proud of our girls. And I'm grateful to them, and I'm grateful to Connell for indulging me in this endeavor, for all of their support, and for their own sacrifices. Thank you with all my heart. I look forward to the honor and privilege of serving our great city for the next 2 years. Thank you.
Before I recognize the wonderful City of Fairfax Band for rendition of America the Beautiful, I would just like to recognize our distinguished congressman has joined us, Congressman Jerry Connolly. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. We will now have the swearing in of the members of the school board. I'd like to note that two members of the school board were not able to be here tonight, Carolyn S. Pitches and Robert M. Reinsel. They were sworn in previously, so let's give them a round of applause, because I'm sure they'll be watching. I'd now like to welcome Fairfax County Circuit Court Clerk John T. Fry for the oath of office.
If you rise, raise your right hand and repeat after me. I do solemnly swear.
I do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
I will support the Constitution of the United States of America.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
And the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
That I will faithfully and impartially discharge.
Faithfully and impartially discharge.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
All the duties incumbent upon me.
As a school board member.
As a school board member.
For the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
For the City of Fairfax, Virginia.
According to the best of my ability, so help me God.
According to the best of my ability, so help me God.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. I would now like to have Electoral Board Chairman Rick Harrington for the presentation of certificates of election.
Mr. Mayor? To all whom these present shall come, greetings. This is to certify that John A. Buttram was duly elected member school board.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you. To all whom these present shall come, greetings. This is to certify Tobin Mary Sorensen was duly elected member school board. To all whom these present shall come, greetings. This is to certify Mitchell A. Sutterfield was duly elected member school board.
And I remember you out there campaigning.
I would now like to invite each member of the school board to present some brief comments, starting with John A. Buttram.
Thank you. Thank you, Dan. There's only three school board members here this evening, so the school board's already saving you 6 minutes this evening. You can thank us later for that. My colleagues on the school board, mayor, city councils, city and school board staffs, honored guests, family, friends, and neighbors. So here we are again. And again, I tell you that for me, this is an honor and a privilege. For this, I give thanks to my family for their unfailing support, my colleagues on the board for their efforts on my behalf, numerous friends, supporters, well-wishers, and especially you, the voters, who believe in our schools, who see their value to our community, who are willing to entrust their care to me as a member of the school board. I am truly humbled by this trust. At this point, I could speak on the successes of our schools and on the challenges ahead, and if time permitted, I'd be happy to do so, but as you know, I must be brief. So yes, there are challenges to be met. You know these as the budget, maintaining our wonderful schools and providing the support our students deserve. As for successes, our students continue to excel in academics, sports, the arts, and in numerous club activities. Our schools are working hard to provide the opportunities and challenges to our children while closing achievement gaps. I think we on the board could speak volumes and with great pride of our students' accomplishments. When I meet these students, I'm constantly amazed at their drive, their imagination, and their growing sense of purpose. This gives me faith that our future is in good hands. To get a sense of this, you need only look at last week's commencement speaker at Fairfax, Fairfax alum and Army First Lieutenant Jason Pack, who, though grievously injured in Afghanistan, provided inspiration in his personal story of recovery, and his words to the class are nurturing resilience, letting life's obstacles and troubles serve as a motivation to succeed. I'm convinced this board, with the help of this community, will continue to provide for our children's education and growth, and with luck be witnesses to their success. Before I end tonight, I'd like to congratulate and thank a few folks. First, congratulations to Nancy and Janice for their election to City Council, and welcome Bob Reinsel to the school board. I think the city will benefit well from these leaders. To Steve and Dan, thank you for your service to the community and your support to our schools. I know it doesn't end here. To Janice Miller, I think it's all been said, but just in case, dedicated, caring, effective, tireless. But one more time, I want to take the opportunity to say thank you. Thank you for your service to the city's schools and their children. Thank you for your friendship and mentorship, and thank you for your leadership. The City Council's gain will be our gain. And finally, to my wife, Sharon, and my sons, Sam and Ben, I give thanks daily for their support, their patience, their persistence in keeping me focused on what's important, and for their love and belief in what I do. Thank you very much. Have a good evening.
I would now like to welcome School Board Member Toby Sorensen.
Good evening. I would first like to thank all our elected officials, past, present, and future, and particularly to my good friend Janice Miller as she leaves school board and begins her new adventure on City Council. I would also like to thank my family. I would like to thank all the voters and residents of the City of Fairfax. Being reelected to the school board for the fourth time is an incredible honor. You know, when the topic is education, we spend so much time on students' academic achievement. How much do they know? How well do they know it? And, oh yes, how well do they compare, read, compete with others in our region, our country, and even the world? But this evening, I'd like to focus on an area of educational experience that our children receive simply by virtue of living here in the environs of Washington, D.C., and in our own little city. Our children experience the world right here in our public schools. Thanks to the ethnic, religious, and socioeconomic diversity of their classrooms, they receive lessons they could never get from a textbook, a computer, or an app. World events and turmoil that are reported in the Washington Post result in students showing up at our school doors, both evacuating U.S. citizens and refugees from other countries. They become classmates with children who have never been outside of Virginia. Images of people from other countries become more nuanced when one goes to school with basketball players from Mongolia or African students who speak with a British accent due to an education in England. They meet American-born students who are fluent in foreign languages thanks to years lived abroad. Our kids study with Asian and Indian youngsters who once attended stellar and demanding institutions in their home countries, but whose parents want them to acquire an American education. They become friends with exchange students from Germany, Spain, Norway, the Faroe Islands. Look that up on your map of the North Atlantic. I did. And they attend school with children whose families have fled violence and poverty in faraway lands, who come here with nothing. And what does this great meeting of cultures offer to all the children in our schools? Each morning, when they stop their lessons to recite the Pledge of Allegiance, they learn that American nationality is not shaped by race, ethnicity, or religion, but by an idea. They see the idea in practice through the study of U.S. history and government, through participation in student government and student-produced media, even in elementary school. They witness parent involvement in school and the opportunity to express opinions through community forums and online surveys. And probably, most fundamentally, they see their schools used as polling places on election day. So besides learning English and math and science and history, they come to know what it is to be a member of a world community and what an amazing role our American democracy has in that world. Schools are not perfect places, and we always strive to do better. But for this, we should be proud. Thank you.
now like to welcome Mitch, school board member Mitch Sutterfield.
You're shorter than I am, Toby. First, my thanks to all of you for coming out. As you have heard from all the elected officials that have gathered here in front of you, we do not serve alone. We all need support. We all need someone who believes in what we do. And so, special thanks to Carolyn, my wife and campaign treasurer, who gives me love and fiscal discipline from the same source. I also wish Godspeed and salute to Madam Chair Janice Miller as she takes up her duties on the City Council. At this, my third swearing in, I'm getting a sense of a typical year on your city school board. Not surprisingly, our year follows the pattern that you're familiar with your kids in the schools. In August, we visit summer programs that enrich our kids. September, well, we all know how busy and exciting September is, all those orientations and back-to-school events. In early October, we receive an estimate of how many of our city's kids are in our schools. This begins a discussion of what will be a recurring beat throughout the city year. I'm talking about the budget. November brings our state convention. December is appropriate for a dinner with friends. In our case, our partners, the staff and members of the Fairfax County School Board. As we begin the new year, the superintendent, currently Dr. Noonan, comes and shares with us some refinements and updates of his proposal for the budget. February brings our State of the Schools reports. Each of our four principals, like Mr. Goldfarben back there, informs us of the progress our children are making. At the end of March, we receive a final count of our students with its effect on, wait for it, the budget. April is a special month, our student panel. It's a chance to look at our whole enterprise from the viewpoint of those we ultimately serve, the students. Later that month and into May, the superintendent and the board, with the ultimate backing of the City Council, thank you very much, pound into shape what we hope are the final numbers of the budget. Then in June, graduation, final recognition of student achievement, a retreat for our board, and if it's an election year like now, our reconstitution of ourselves in July. In the midst of these routines, comfortable as they are, comes an occasional derecho, situations that have to be dealt with. Facilities are often a lively topic, renovations, repairs of storm damage, ad hoc upgrades, monopoles, fieldhouse lights, press boxes. Personnel turnover also crops up, sometimes unexpectedly. We have in recent years replaced and hired some excellent people in Sisson House over there right behind you. Our major accomplishment this past term remains our urgent and successful school boundary adjustment, which right-sized three of our four schools, at least for the time being. To close then, no matter what may come up, the key to our success in the school board year as in the classroom is listening. That is our real continuity, even more than that budget. We listen all year to parents, students, teachers. We listen to several advisory groups. We listen to our colleagues on other school boards in our region and state, and we listen to many experts from Fairfax City, Fairfax County, and beyond to give us more information. As the kids proceed in their education, so do we. And so I promise we will continue to do so. Thank you. Thank you for your support and good wishes.
We have now come to the end of this wonderful evening. And first, let me say congratulations and good luck to everyone. I know you'll do our community proud. This evening would not have happened with a lot of support, a lot of help, and a lot of leadership within our community. I'd like to thank Bob Sisson, our city manager, Melanie Burrell, our city clerk. I'd like to thank Reverend Dr. Johnson Adosimwan, Rachel Harrington, our vocalist, Boy Scout Troop 1887, our wonderful City of Fairfax band, City Screen 12 crew, who will make all of us look very, very good, especially as we go into HD, our City of Fairfax Police and Fire Honor Guards, our Parks and Recreation Department, and our Public Works Department. But thanks again, everyone, for coming. This closes our ceremony, and I please invite you to go to the back to enjoy some refreshments at our reception. Thank you very much, and have a good evening.